In this video, let's talk about the future of virtual production and motion tracking with disguise.
All right, real quick, you're watching Video Brand. Special thanks to our sponsors for making this NAB coverage possible. Massive, Metricool, Adspective, Vestigit, and OpenReel. All right, back to the video. All right, what's up? I'm here with Nick from disguise. So Nick, first off, kind of just brief overview. What Disguise is, what it does.
Yeah, Disguise is the Emmy award-winning platform for, I would say, visual experiences. We're the engine behind so many things that you've seen from major award shows, sporting events, live broadcasts, to concerts and entertainment. And we're the system that allows you to be creative and power amazing large-scale visual experiences, and now experiences in things like broadcast and virtual production.
Nice, and what are some of the new updates you got here at NAB?
Yeah, I would say the first big thing we're showing off is our toolkit for what we kind of call extended reality, so which is taking the concepts of virtual production and applying that to the broadcast hemisphere and also the corporate side of things. The second really exciting thing we're showing is Move.ai integration with Disguise, and that is effectively markerless motion captures. It's really what I say is just magic, is you can now just walk onto a stage, onto a volume, and track people without having to put anything on them. So historically, motion capture, you're in a suit. This really changes the game for people, say like broadcasters, where they can't go put on a suit and also be on air. And now we can do that and turn you into avatars, track you, and do some pretty incredible new things.
That's awesome. Is it able to kind of just track your whole limbs, arms, body?
Yeah, exactly. So it uses a 6-camera cluster around you, and it visibly tracks you and understands you via AI.
Nice. AI has kind of been a hot topic. Have you sort of seen any other integrations or like future pathways of like how, even if it's like tracking or just generating the scenes, we've seen some other kind of options of like typing in a prompt and now you have like you're in a new world or something based on generative AI.
Yeah, I think the big thing is, you know, this technology is getting so good, it's now allowing the core, which is content creation, and that's the core of everything we do in the world now is around video and telling stories, and that's what we really want to do is empower that, and the technology is really starting to take more of a backseat to allow creative to run faster with new tools. You can create in so many different paradigms and applications, and it's kind of the mix and match of that that allows you to be the most creative and have the most creative potential, and I think that's what's really kind of exploding right now is we all now know how the technology works, so now we can really push it.
Mm-hmm. So yeah, I mean, virtual production kind of been a big hot thing, and set up here and what projects Disguise kind of works on is large scale or large broadcast projects. Do you see a pathway too for like making virtual production more accessible? I know we've seen some other kind of pop-ups here of like more accessible tools if like you're kind of trying to get started in virtual production.
Yeah, definitely. I mean, we're seeing that all over the market right now is, I think, you know, kind of on that note, it's that virtual production, I think a lot of people thought it was just this big scale, these big volumes, and people are, and people are starting to realize that there's more attainable sizes. I mean, we're even building things that are 10 feet right now. You know, that's very much on the opposite end, but it serves specific needs. And I think people are starting to realize that virtual production doesn't just mean large volume, it means tool set. And I think that's the thing that's really interesting is now we're seeing these kind of new use cases where volumes might be getting a little bit smaller, which makes them more accessible. They're serving more specific needs, which helps those content creators.
Yeah, cool. Well, thanks, Nick. I really appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you.
All right, thanks for watching. Be sure to check all of our NAB videos over here in our NAB playlist. And be sure to hit the subscribe button for more videos like this. Thanks for watching. I'll catch you in the next episode.